Would you like to get paid before you start the work? Well, then you will have to record a job deposit down payment in QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Job deposits can also be called down payments. It's a payment before the work is done on a job, also called payments in advance. It's normal to receive some payment before starting work. In QuickBooks Online, here are two possible ways that you could record job deposit payments in advance of the work done. The video that follows this one will show one method for receiving payments in advance, and then the next video after that will show the other method for a different job. This way, you can experience and see the results of both methods looking at it at two different jobs. There are two ways to record deposit down payments in QuickBooks Online. You could use the credit memo method, or you could use the QuickBooks Online invoice deposit feature. Now, if you use the credit method, it means that the credit memo that you generate when you get the advanced payment is the receipt that you would give to the client for the down payment. It makes the job and client balance negative until some work is done and an invoice is actually made. Customers' balances are accurate after each transaction. That means that if you use the credit memo method and you look at any of the reports that show the customer's balance, at any given moment, that balance will be correct. However, it does require a simple accountant adjustment if you need to report your financial statements after you got the down payment, but before you did any work on the job. Now let's compare that to the other method, the QuickBooks Online invoice deposit feature method. Well, it uses the first or only job invoice as the receipt for the deposit down payment. The customer's records will not show an accurate balance until the work is done on the job if you use this second method. Deposit down payment will not be listed as a separate transaction in the customer records. In other words, you record the first invoice and part of the invoice is the down payment deposit. It also requires an accountant adjustment if you are reporting your financial numbers from your chart of accounts after you got the deposit, but before the work is done. Now let's set up two estimates, one for each method that will be demonstrated in the videos that follow this one. Let's make estimate number 3 for the Southwood Roads job under Kirschbaum, and we'll make estimate number 4, and that'll be under the Mockingbird Lane job under Brown Company. We will put in the memo field of the estimate the method of the deposit down payment that we're going to use. Then we will demonstrate each method in the following two videos. Estimate number 3 will be for the Kirschbaum Southwoods Road job. We'll date it February 1, and it will have 30 units of carpentry at $45 each, 30 of electrical work at $40 each, 30 mason work at $35, and 30 replacement parts at $30 each. But the most important thing we will put in this estimate for this video will be the credit memo method that we'll write in the message at the bottom so we remember how we got paid and what method we're using for this job. Well, it's very simple. Just like we learned in a previous video, we click New, Estimate, Now, mine came up as number four because I messed up my number three. So I'm going to change this to number three, but you don't have to. Yours should already say number three unless you also went ahead and deleted and went back. Now, this is for the Kirschbaum job, but specifically the Southwoods Road job under Kirschbaum. And the estimate date is February 1. And let's read off the products and services, 30 of each, carpentry, electrical work, mason work, and replacement parts. Again, carpentry, 30, electrical, 30, and I believe it was mason work and replacement parts. Mason work, you can put this in any order you like, 30, and replacement parts, 30, parts, not pipes. Be careful. Now, I like to put the rate last because we would probably charge a different rate for each item depending on the client. 45, 40, 35, 30. So, 45, 40, 35, 30. Now we have our estimate for a total of $4,500. But the most important thing to remember in this video is that somewhere in the bottom of this estimate, we should record credit memo given as deposit receipt. So that tells us the method that we're using for this estimate and this job. Save and close. And now let's make estimate number four. Estimate number four is for the Mockingbird Lane job under Brown Company. We will date it February 2nd, 35 dewinterizing, 35 replacement parts, steam cleaning, and electrical work. And somewhere at the bottom of the estimate, we will write down a note that we are using the invoice deposit method in the next video to receive the money for the down payment before we start the work. We click New, Estimate, and QuickBooks remembers we're up to estimate number four. And this is for the Mockingbird Lane job under Brown Company. And the date is February 2nd. Now let's make sure we put in the items properly. 35 of each, dewinterizing, replacement parts, steam cleaning, and electrical work. So dewinterizing, replacement pipes. Make sure it's pipes and not parts. Steam cleaning. And electrical work. And how many of each? 35. And what's the rate for each of these? Remember, we charge a different rate for each customer and each job. 40, 50, 40, 50, respectively. Okay, now the total for this estimate is $6,350, and again, at the bottom, we should put a memo. The method of recording the down payment was the invoice deposit method. So we know what to expect. Now we click Save and Close. and we're finished preparing for the next video, but let's just double check the two reports that show the estimates. Do you remember which two they were? Transaction list by customer and estimates and progress invoicing summary by customer. We click the reports tab, go to custom reports, and when we go down to transaction list by customer, we can see that under the